In terms of what works sort of editorially for users, I think web video, it has to be created for the web. It has to have, the successful web video has some distinct properties. It's generally short, like can be really short, as short as 30 seconds. You know, anything that's as long as 4 minutes has a lot of cards stacked against it. It has to have humor. Doesn't mean it has to be comedy, but using humor is, you know, kind of gives it that potential for spreading, for viral spread. And it has to be, I think it is even more viral in nature than non-video content. That is because nobody generating a huge amount of video traffic on their own sites. I mean, the networks, you know, a certain amount for news. But other than YouTube, right, if you're, you know, if you're any other kind of website, you're depending for video on people following viral links. And so you have to think about what about a video is going to cause it to spread in a contagious way. And usually that is some kind of pithy thing that it adds or does, or a way that it's expressed or broken down. It really has to add, it has to have value in a very particular way, because it's not a form of overall regular consumption of news. And it can be an imposition, right? It's generally a pretty bad experience when you watch it on websites. I mean, those pre-roll ads are terrible, nobody likes them, you don't want to watch a 30-second ad before you watch a 60-second video. It's sort of not a good experience. And sites, it's one of these trends that media sites really kind of piled into without having necessarily a theory of the case, either in terms of how you created differentiated content that was valuable or what the business was. I mean, I think a lot of sites started creating video, invested a lot of money into it, and looked around and said, yeah, the CPMs are high, but there's so few views that there's no way you can support the cost of making the video. Now, for a site like Slate, we like making video because we feel like we have a specific tone and approach, and you know, we do things, and we think certain things we do are best done in video. The business defense is not that we, you know, make money on every video, but rather that having that capacity helps you sell big advertising programs that have video as a component. But weirdly, I think podcasting is a fundamentally much better business. It's a much better advertising model. You have host reads, which is the model of old-time radio, where the broadcasters doing the show stop and talk about the sponsor for a minute, which you don't allow the equivalent in video or, you know, or in print, but that's how it's always worked on radio, so it's sort of okay in podcasting. You have very high CPMs, you have this the most intense engagement with audiences, and the cost of productions are much lower than video because you don't need all the video equipment. But, you know, go figure, people are still pumping a ton of money into video and very little other than us into podcasting.